Welcome back, everyone. So let's talk about shallow copy and deep copy. So in this, if you heard about shallow copy is just a copy by reference. And deep copy is total isolation where object A is assigned to object B, but there is no linking. So here, this is the pure example of shallow copy where I have A is variable in object A and I copied the A to B and I assigned A dot A is equal to 2. And what should be the value of B dot A is, because here I'm getting the value 2. Why? You might have surprised it. I assigned the value in the A, but object B also impacted because both are pointing to the same memory reference. So this is a copy by reference. So if you change anything in the B or A, both will get impacted and the value is getting printed accordingly. Can we fix this problem using object.assign? So like A has A is 1 and I assign the object B and then object.assign and I'm passing the object A here, trying to create object B, then I assigned A dot A is equal to 2, but B is still coming, B dot A is still coming 1. So we somehow try to manage this property where B dot A is coming equal to 1. Because B has been copied to the object A. Now, whatever you do with A, either you delete the property, either you reassign some property, it's not going to impact the object B because B is isolated copy. Similarly, you can do with that similarly using triple dot operator. So here, there is object A and object B I have copied. So I assigned A dot A is equal to 2. So B is not impacted by it. B dot A is still pointing to 1. So that is the one way of solving the problem by object.assign. But object.assign will also help you if the property of A is enumerable and configurable false. Now, how we can do a deep copy? Deep copy you can do using JSON object json.stringify. You have the object A, you stringify it, then you copy that object by parsing it to another object. That is the another way of doing a copy, right? First stringify A, then parse it and assign it to some other object. Okay, so that is not going to impact whatever you change in the first object will not be impacted by second object because second object is a brand new copy. But json.stringify can't make a deep copy of this object. So you can see object A has a A and B has a C and D, two other properties. So if object is circularly referenced like the above example, you will find a method json.parse, json.stringify that cannot do a deep copy of a nested JSON object. So what is the other way around? You can use a deep clone method of Lodash, or you can iterate on object A, get each and every property from object A and assign it to the object B. That is the another way. First, another way is like first iterate onto the object.keys of object A and get all the keys from object A and assign one by one to the object B. So this is a separate copy. We are not doing a reference assignment here. Okay. So if you do the direct like A equal to B, then it's a shallow copy. You will never achieve it. Somehow it is fixed by object.assign. Later we started using json.stringify to create isolated link. But that also doesn't work. So the only thing which is left is if there's a plain JavaScript object, use json.stringify or iterate on to the object A keys and assign separately to the object B, or use deep clone method of Lodash, or write your own function to do a deep copy. Create object, so there is a deep, create a deep copy function, create an empty object, and iterate onto the object A and start assigning the new keys from object A to B. This way you will just create a copy. So call apply bind, this is another important question. How you can override the definition of this object using call apply bind. Right? So this is the get value function, which is where we are passing the name and age. Right? So in this, what we are doing, get value dot call, I am passing the a object. So get value dot call, and I'm passing two values, name and age. Okay, but what will be the value of this dot value? Because there is no value property in object in this function. So where this value property will come from? So here, this call method will allow me to override the definition of this object and pass this a object inside this function. So this dot value will give you one. So the call and apply and bind are actually used to override the definition of this object. Bind is used like you have a nested callback functions, where inside a nested functions you don't have a definition of this object, then you put dot bind there. Call we are using to override the this object. So consider you have a three properties in object A, x, y, z, and you wanted to use them using this dot x, this dot y, this dot z in this function. But this function doesn't have those variables. Then how this function will give you this dot x, this dot y, this dot z? In that case, you need to override the this definition and you need to pass this a object using dot call. In this case, this function will have values of this dot a, this dot x, this dot y, this dot z. Okay. Similarly, the apply, in the apply, we are passing the argument in an array. So this is all about in the first segment. I will be launching another more videos on JavaScript interview questions.